What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Bailey Kramer, and in this video, I'm going to show you behind the scenes of how I run my Airbnb business and everything you need to have in place if you're going to be hiring a virtual assistant. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump in. All right, so you're looking at my screen right now, and this is my Notion dashboard. Notion's a software. You can use Notion if you want. You can use Google Docs. You can use a different software. It doesn't matter. I'm just going to show you what works for my business, and you can choose to replicate what you see here. If you want to grab this exact snapshot, though, and everything I'm going to show you, you can do so down below in the description. So first things first, in this Notion dashboard, here are all the different things that I have. I'm not going to go through each and every single one of them, but I will go through the main ones. So first off is a hiring listing for a virtual assistant. So talks about the job interview, the key responsibilities, and this weeds out who you want and what skills you want them to have and who you don't want to have. So you can use this exact job listing on sites like Upwork, Online Jobs PH, or any other site that you want. Now, once you actually hire a virtual assistant, one of the biggest mistakes I see is people blame their virtual assistant for not just instantly knowing exactly what is in your head. So what I created here is the guest messaging playbook. Now, what's cool is you can take this and, of course, make it your own. So, for example, I have scenarios where if a guest inquires, if we have an instant booking, if we have a maintenance issue, if the guest doesn't respond to messages after they booked, what exactly my virtual assistant should say. So let's just give an example here. Guest inquiry. So anytime a guest inquires about any property, you are going to go to canned responses on hospitable and select inquiry response. It will look like the message below. So I'm literally writing out, this is an SOP, the step-by-step that my virtual assistant needs to do when an inquiry comes in, okay? And then there's even more instructions here. And I have a bunch of scenarios as well that I give my virtual assistant so we can practice on fake scenarios. That way, when we have an actual guest inquiry come in, they know exactly what to do. So I'll just give you a quick preview here. We have scenarios for instant booking, maintenance issues, exactly what to say and how to solve them. And then what happens if a guest doesn't respond to a message after they booked. All right, next up, we have training and support documents. So these are, again, kind of what you just saw in this guest messaging playbook, but for pre-booking, once the booking is accepted, during their stay, certain training videos like in there, what to do post-checkout, okay, certain instructions that we have. And of course, again, what you can do is take this and make it your own because we're going to have different ways of running our businesses, but you can use this as a really good solid template. All right, next up, we have the property organizer. This is one of the key things that I use to ensure that all the information about the properties in my head are actually on this screen. So starting with the basics, like the property address, the Airbnb listing links, right? The homeowner information, if you're co-hosting, this is where you put the homeowner's information. If you aren't co-hosting and these are just your own properties, you can just delete this. Vendor and resources. So who's your cleaner? What's their information? Runner, handyman, all your people, all your vendors, you're going to put them here. And then property information so that any question that a guest asks will be in here. Okay, so there's a bunch of them. So that's what the property organizer is all about. Now, next up, let's go to the daily checklist. So this is a checklist of everything I want my virtual assistant to be doing as soon as they start their shift. So respond to any unanswered messages on hospitable, send out follow-up inquiries, check the calendar, make sure that there's no block-off date unintentionally, schedule review requests, check the batteries on the door locks. Okay, all these different things I have them do. And what's cool is I have videos attached to each of these, okay? So I can show them exactly what to do. If they forget, they can watch the video, and if they still don't understand anything, of course, they can ask. So that's a daily checklist, okay? And then a couple extra bonuses. So we have the expense report. This is what we send to our owners at the end of every single month to let them know the revenue and the expenses, a couple other bonuses and different option of templates here. And then we have some ChatGPT commands that we can use to help enhance our listings, a template on building the dream team and all the vendors you're going to need, and of course, a maintenance tracker so you can keep track of all the different things that your property needs and when they were last replaced. HVAC filters, door batteries, refrigerator filters, and all that good stuff. So again, if you guys want all these templates, you can grab it in the link down below. This is essential if you are going to be hiring people, whether it's a virtual assistant or somebody else, to run the day-to-day operations for your business. So again, grab it down below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.